Hey, what's up? I'm going to show you how I set up my system preferences. This is a request from a subscriber who just got a new Mac. I'm going to run you through my preferences. Just a friendly reminder, this is how I set them up and not necessarily exactly how you should, so just take whatever you like and yeah. Let's go ahead and get started. So I'm going to run through these one by one, and if there's no changes, I'll just kind of skip over it. Some of them I'll have to skip over for security purposes. As I run through them, I'll just mention the ones that I made changes to, as I just said. Sorry for the repetition. Okay, I like dark mode much better. That you probably noticed if you watch my videos. Accent color, this little highlighter one, I don't know where it comes up though. I go ahead and change to Google Chrome, and then for recent items, when you go to a program and do File, Open, Recent Items, I like to have the maximum here. Desktop and screensaver, I just have my custom little star gazing thing with my name in it, or my star constellation. You have to put any pictures inside of your username folder slash pictures. You can go to your desktop and then do command up, and then you can go to pictures here, or just search pictures inside of Alfred by doing pictures. There you go. Next, dock and menu bar. There's a lot of settings here for the control center that I never really use, but I go ahead and change my dock settings actually by right clicking on this little line here, and I turn hiding off, or I turn hiding on rather. And I don't turn magnification on, I turn magnification off, and position on screen is left, because when you have it at the bottom and you try to resize a window, your mouse is at the bottom right of the screen and it interacts with the dock, so this avoids that. They're opening next door. Okay, and minimize using genie effect. Yeah. The reason why I hide my dock is because I'm very easily distracted, and if you have any programs that have badges, it'll show up in the dock. That way I can choose when to see my notifications and the notifications don't choose when to bother me. More on that later. So dock size small all the way because I use Alfred to open up pretty much everything, and magnification I turn off. Moving on. Mission control. I go ahead and turn off all of the spaces stuff. Because spaces is when you have a layout of programs on one space or one desktop that looks like this, but then you can switch to a totally new one. The animation kind of makes me motion sick, so I don't use it. I use the F keys on my keyboard a lot, more on that in a second. So I go ahead and disable everything because I don't use any of these, and I have my own shortcut for show desktop with Alfred. Hot corners, I usually put one of them as put display to sleep, so I can drag my Wacom tablet or mouse to the bottom left and turn off the monitor. At work, I would maybe do lock window, or not lock window, lock screen. Yep, lock screen. And that way I can keep my computer secure at work. Siri, I don't really use enable ask Siri. Yeah, so spotlight, I don't really use that much. If you ever add files to your computer and Alfred doesn't pick them up, you can drag those files into here and then remove them, and Spotlight will automatically re-index that folder that you just dragged in, and it will now show up in Alfred. So hot tip for Alfred. We're on the Alfred video here. Notifications, okay. This is the second time I filmed this video, so I'm gonna show you really quickly. Your notifications are probably all on, and I hate notifications because there's just so many. I use so many programs. So I'm gonna write a little script for you and I'll post it. Check out this video on how I automate my job to learn how to do this. But essentially I'm gonna write a script to go through and disable the notifications one by one if you have a lot of programs. Okay, so I'm gonna do new Apple script, disable notes. Okay, I'm gonna do tele, system preferences to activate. Then I'm going to click on allow notifications. So mouse, click allow. But it would be don't allow. And then I'll push the down key. So activate system events, down key. Okay, and then I'm gonna loop it for however many programs you have. I would usually do 10 at a time. So loop, setup. Okay, now if you just want to not learn how to do this little script and use this script, all you have to do is do Shift Command 4 as if you're taking a screenshot, see where the numbers are over the toggle switch for allow notifications, and then replace the XY coordinates right here. I'll go ahead and leave you a note. Replace XY coordinates here. Okay, so I'm gonna go ahead and turn on the notifications for these, and I'm gonna do an example. So I'll do 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Okay, so I'll start at the first one and then run my script, disable notes. I'll do it 7 times. Boom, yes, yay, there go all of them. Cool, so you can do a little script like that to quickly handle all of those. And then I would recommend going through which programs you do actually want notifications for if that is the case. Moving on. Internet accounts, these are just pretty basic things to set up your email. I'll skip over that for security purposes. I don't use Wallet and Apple Pay too much. I don't like to use Touch ID. I prefer a password. Don't want anyone cutting off my finger. Not that that's a thing. Users and groups. The most important thing here is to go to login items and make sure that any programs that you don't want to start up at the beginning, you go ahead and take off. If you don't recognize it, take it off, because when you start a program, it'll automatically load the stuff that it needs. It's just trying to get a head start. If you just have a new Mac, your Mac is very fresh and clean, so this is a good way to keep it starting quickly. A good way for it to start quickly. Accessibility, I don't use too much. There are a couple cool things you can do, like dictation. Security and privacy, this is where you can restrict apps and the access that they have to your computer. Whenever an app requests something on your computer, it'll have a pop-up window come up and have you add it at that time. For a lot of the things I use, Alfred, Better Touch Tool, Size Up, Script Editor, all the stuff, it comes up each time. Just a note. File Vault, if you want to encrypt your hard drive, so if someone tries to get into it, it'll be encrypted unless you enter the password and you have a recovery key. Definitely recommend doing. It does take a while to set up, but it is something that is good. Software update will be where you update the Mac OS. I think I actually have an update to do now, and you'll get notified here versus the App Store where software updates for Mac OS previously were. Network, this is just controls for your Ethernet and your Wi-Fi. Pretty self-explanatory, nothing fancy there. It's Bluetooth, same thing with that. Whenever I'm trying to connect a device to my laptop, I have to open up this window for my computer to be discoverable. That may or may not be true in all cases, that's just my experience. Sound, this is where you can switch the sound and make aggregate devices. Basically, if you wanna make your Wi-Fi speaker and your computer be one sound output, you can do that there. Printers and scanners, pretty self-explanatory. I have a whole video on this, I'll put a link there, but running through it quickly, I do use F1 keys and F2, so it'll switch the standard functions for my F keys to be F1 to 12 or 16 or 18 or whatever it is. It's 16, 17, somewhere in between. And then if you wanna do the sound key, you'll have to push function sound key. But I use a lot of keyboard shortcuts to do that. Text, I usually do some text replacement. So if I type in, oh well, it'll do this. You can set that up there or in Typeinator. I have another video on that. Shortcuts, I go ahead and disable spotlight because I like Alfred to use the command space keyboard shortcut. I have a couple, app shortcuts like make a new folder. I'll also have a video on that. And then for dictation, I have it off, but if you do a keyboard shortcut, you can start dictating to the Mac and it'll start typing for you and doing other things, I think. Oh, also for shortcuts here, I make sure to use keyboard navigation to move focus. So that way when you push tab, you can go through all of the options and it makes your computer much more controllable by the keyboard. Cool, flying through this. All right, trackpad, I go ahead and disable the scroll and zoom because I don't like it that much. And then for mouse, I also disable the smart zoom, the secondary click. And for more gestures, I just take away the swipe. And I'll take away that because I just don't use it a lot on my mouse that I have. And yeah, that's that. Tracking speed, you can control at your leisure if you'd like it to be slower. Displays, if you do have a display or on your laptop display, you can go to scaled, and I like to choose the biggest space possible. Color, I just keep it to whatever it is by default, and then night shift, I probably should turn this on. I'll just do sunset to sunrise. I will turn that off because I use a program called Flux. Flux is my little it controls the color temperature of my screen. And what I do is I just manually do it and just keep it there because I like it like that all the time. Moving on, battery. I usually do battery and I do for 1 hour. I disable enable power nap. I disable put hard disk to sleep when possible, because if I'm uploading something or doing something or away from my computer and letting an automation run, or just, you know, I like to know when my computer is on and I make sure to turn it off every night or put it to sleep when I'm not using it, but that's why I do that. You can schedule things like that here as well. Also with the power adapter, I wouldn't recommend never, but I would recommend a long time for when you're turning your display off. Also for power adapter, I disable these settings here. Date and time, I use 24 hour time, and I think that's in language and region. Yeah, which is next. Actually, I skipped over it. So language and region, I use 24 hour times, and you can go here and set certain apps for certain languages. Let me try to do it. I'll do IA Writer, which is another program that I like. In French. So let's try it out. IA Writer. Cool. Presentation. So that's cool. Sans titre. I think I'll leave that. So that's pretty cool too, if you want to practice another language that you might speak. All right. Sharing. I disable everything. This is a very big security risk. So I disable everything. And you can turn it on when you need it, but always turn it off afterwards. Never leave your computer open in any way. Time machine, I don't use. I put everything on Dropbox, but that's a pretty easy setup. You just choose a hard drive and you just plug it in and it does its thing. Pretty reliable from what I hear. My mom uses it. Startup disk is whenever you put in a USB disk and you want to load from a USB drive. That's what you would do. Hazel, that's a whole program and that's how you access the preferences. I won't go into that. I have a video on that. How I organize my downloads. And then lastly, Wacom tablet, if you do have one. Also have a video on that. I feel like Vanna White now because I just figured out how to put the info cards and apparently it helps with SEO. Okay, so just quickly what I do for the pin, I do this as a space bar. So this here, so I do keystroke space bar. I do just one monitor and yeah, that's it. You can set different settings for each program by clicking here, which is pretty cool. Sometimes in Photoshop, maybe I'd want to change the functions of the pin, but I always forget that it's different, and so just use one standard across the board. One thing that I forgot in keyboard is I put key repeat all the way fast and delay until repeat all the way fast. Also have a video specifically on keyboard preferences. All right, I'll leave it at that. Sorry I went through it super fast, but I want to present the information efficiently and not take up too much of your time. Thank you so much for watching. If anyone has any requests, send them over and I'll get to it as soon as I can. And as always, you can email me at hello@theproductivityshop.co or join the Slack channel. Thank you so much for watching and I'll see you later.
Nailed it.
Hey, what's up? I'm gonna show you how I set up my system preferences. This is a surprise. Hey, what's up? I'm gonna show, hey, what's up? Damn it. Hey, what's up? Oh, let me turn off the fan. Okay. Hey, what's up? I'm gonna show you how I set up my system preferences. This is a subscriber request to just, hey, what's up? I'm gonna show you how I set up my system preferences. This is a request from a subscriber who just got a new Mac. I'm gonna run you through my preferences. Just a friendly reminder, this is how I set them up and not necessarily exactly how you should. So just take whatever you like and yeah, let's go ahead and get started.